Yeah, assalamu alaikum and a very good day everyone. My name is Zaki and I'll be your instructor to discuss the topic on authentication and cryptography. Okay, the objective of this topic, at the end of this topic, you should be able to understand what is authentication and what is cryptography in the information technology security. The topic covered in this topic is what is authentication, what is password, what is cryptographic concept, how the cryptographic algorithm will be, the digital signature, public key infrastructure, the RSA algorithm, and the method of attack in encryption system. Okay, first we're going to discuss what is authentication is. Okay, the use of the authentication is to provide the mechanism to achieve the confidentiality and also the integrity of data in information security. Authentication is defined as the verification of identity of someone who generated some data, and it relates to identity verification. Or in other words, what we can say is how you're going to prove that you are the one who you're claiming to be. Okay, authentication can be achieved by using the some identity verification. For example, like what we always do in logging in our online account is by using something known, like a password. Or second, you can use by something possessed, for example, like your smart card and your passport. And the third one, you can use whatever that you have on your physical, or we call it as a physical characteristic or the biometrics. Like uses your fingerprints, your retina eyes, even your voice. And finally, we can use what we call as a voluntary action, such as signature. Okay, why do we need authentication? Okay, we need to have an authentication so that we can verify the message came from an apparent source or outer. Second, we need to make sure that the content that we receive have not been altered in the middle. Third, sometime it was sent at a certain time or at a sequence. And finally, we use authentication to protect against the active attacks. Okay, next I will explain on the protection of password. Password must be kept to yourself and not to be shared to anybody else. And then we don't have to write our password anywhere that we like. For example, on a sticky notes, and then but we stick it on the side of the monitor or we'll put it on the table, because that will be easily be found by somebody else. Okay. Next, how to make sure that you have a very good password. The first thing that you need to have is choosing a good password. You must choose a good password which is hard to guess but it's easy to remember. And then the next one is the characters must not shorter than 6 characters and not pattern from the keyboard. Okay, what we mean by not pattern from the keyboard is by just choosing a password which is like QWERTY, which is QWERTY, as what you can see on your keyboard. Okay. The best way of creating a good password is by remembering some phrases. Okay, but then you only take the first word of every word in the phrase. Okay, you will see the example after this. Okay, then if your password is not that very good, okay, it's actually easy for people to actually guess your password. Firstly, what they can do is by trying the default password. Okay, this is always happen if it is in devices where when it comes from the manufacturer, okay, they will put a default password on the device. As if you receive it, then you need to actually change the password, because normally the default password can be available online. And secondly, is to not to try or to actually create using a short words less than 6 or characters, because in using a 6 characters, it will be easier for people to crack it. And then try all the words in an electronic dictionary. Okay. Next, to collect information about the user, hobbies, family names, birthday, or try the user, your phone number or your social security number or your IC, which is all this information normally nowadays is available publicly. Okay, and another way of trying to guess your password is by guessing it by using a license plate number, and finally by using a keylogger or a Trojan horse that is implanted in your PC or on your computer. Okay, strategy for educating a user to actually select a good password is by giving them a user education how important is a password is, by using a computer generated password which is going to be a randomly characters, but it's going to be a little bit difficult to remember. And by using a reactive password checking, it mean that when you are creating the password, there will be some indicator that going to show you how easy your password can be cracked, whether it's a good password or very hard to guess and so on. And finally, by using a proactive password checking method, which is maybe if it is an online application, every 3 months, there will be some indicator on that application to remind the user to actually change their password to something else. Okay, and well guys, that is what I have on the first part of this chapter of education and cryptography. I hope this sharing session has given you some new knowledge. See you next time. Assalamualaikum and a very good day.